Well, you see, that's the whole point, is the word lie needs to be defined. Sometimes not telling the truth, all of the truth, is your moral obligation. And you have a moral obligation to tell the whole truth and nothing but the truth at all times to anyone who asks you. You would say, that's not in the Bible. The moral thing to do is for me not to tell you. You ain't getting nothing out of me. Those issues relating to whether you have a moral obligation to tell the whole truth at all times to everyone, that needs to be answered by pointing out you don't. You do not owe them the truth. And see, that's another fallacy. People run around thinking life is just, and they run around thinking you owe the truth to everyone. You don't. That's what the Bible teaches.
That was from Morey's available audio tape from the REF, catalog number J54.
If someone tells you ahead of time that they don't believe that it's wrong to lie, can you believe them for anything they say after that? If someone tells you they believe it's all right to lie, if they get in a pinch, how can you believe them anyway? At any time.
I solicit letters from guys like Perez and Slavikas to attack people and accuse them of crimes and then to mail out across the United States. Is that a part of their work? Or are they some kind of a gangbusters outfit that if they find somebody that's guilty of embezzlement, they'll write them up and get a couple of letters to say, hey, this guy's an embezzler, and then mail it out all over the United States.
He does mention also in the letter that he wants us to return $10,000. So yeah. Not only is he getting sympathy and support from all his listeners, but he also wants us to pay him $10,000.
Yeah, that statement you referred to is right here in this letter from Perez, which is one of the 4 pages Morey had in the mail out. Perez says here, as the arbitrator, well, he was no arbitrator of anything. He says, I hereby rule in favor of the Research and Education Foundation and call upon Gary and Larry Wessels to repent of their theft of ministry funds, to return the $10,000 advanced to them. Well, there's been nothing advanced, y'all. There was $10,000 paid back on a debt that they owed y'all, but you got no advance of any sort, like he's implying. But he's implying, see, that that was a misappropriation of money, that it should be returned to restore to REF all the money stolen from the ministry. Now, that's being sent out, and yet Morey is saying that all the money you send to Truth Seekers Ministry is used 100% for our outreaches. Well, now, who paid for this? Who paid to print this? Who paid to mail this?
On a nonprofit corporation bulk permit. And also, I want to say, Bob, to tie in with that, here's, just for the people watching the video, here's one of his earliest mailings called Urgent Warning, Extremely Confidential. September again, but this was from 1994. Yeah. He seems to do his biggest hits in September. But in this one, Truth Seekers with Bob Morey of the Research and Education Foundation says, Urgent Warning, Emergency Alert, Extremely Confidential. And he goes all through here talking about full financial accountability from the Wessels have been refused and ignored. We're doing all these things. He says our attorneys are now preparing to file a lawsuit to recover ministry funds, and the Wessels are the primary defendants. He goes on to say apparently Wessels kept an unauthorized copy of the ministry mailing list. He says any communication from the Wessels is unethical and may violate certain laws, as such files are the exclusive property of the ministry. He says, in the next paragraph, which I find very interesting, the Wessels are claiming the ministry owes them more than $30,000 for office supplies and furniture. No such expenditures were ever requested, approved, or authorized, nor were receipts or verification of these expenses ever presented to the ministry by the Wessels. And he goes on to say, the action of the Wessels brothers is distressing to me. And then he goes on to say, as you were mentioning, the 100% for outreaches. And then he goes on and talks a little bit more about the unfortunate situation. I've enclosed a reply card to respond to this letter today. Of course, if you feel led to do so, I'd really appreciate your vote of confidence and gift of support. Your friend and partner, Dr. Robert A. Morey. And then what do we see on the next page? I don't know if the camera can see this, but it says, here's my vote of confidence. Dear Mr. Morey, I believe in you and the work God has called you to. You can count on my continued prayers and support in this ministry's outreaches despite opposition and attacks. Keep on proclaiming the gospel, defending the faith, and doing what's right. I'm including my emergency ministry support of first box, $100, or you make it whatever, or you can put it on your Visa or MasterCard, send it to Truth Seekers in Newport, Pennsylvania. So here's an outright solicitation of funds based on all these accusations made against us.
Well, Larry, that's why that I specifically said that I felt like that it was a violation of the criminal code, because not only was it a transmission interstate-wise to accuse you of a crime, but it's in a context, in an arrangement that would get money sent to him from people based on this story that he's telling, this falsehood that he's telling, and I clearly believe it falls into the category of extorting, getting money from people because of his accusations against y'all as criminals, and in this way inducing their motivation, moving them to send you offerings, just as the letter said that you quoted a while ago.
Well, I'd also like to mention, I've got the U.S. Postal Inspection Service bylaws and regulations and all of this type of thing. And according to the U.S. Postal Inspection Service, according to the copies of the records I have here, it says at the top, the U.S. Postal Inspection Service's jurisdiction areas of responsibility, it talks about mail fraud. And it says, use of the mails to obtain money or property by means of false or fraudulent pretenses, right, representations, or promises. Right. And it also says, see U.S. 18 U.S.C. 1341 and 1345 for criminal prosecution. It has some other legal jargon here and numbers for reference. Mm-hmm. But it also goes down the page to talk about extortion. And it says here, that portion of the extortion statute concerning a mail threat to injure an individual's reputation or to accuse the individual of a crime. Mm-hmm. Now, to me, Bob, it looks like this is what's taking place. In these mail-outs.
Well, I definitely think so, and I think that this ought to be called the attention of the authorities, that this scheme that Morey and REF have used is a scheme to raise money through a fraudulent accusation that's been made. The fraudulent accusation being made that you all have looted ministry funds and embezzled money, which he has never even bothered to make any charges like that to the agencies, the law enforcement agencies that are really responsible.
Well, let's take an example. They mentioned in their letters that we refused full accountability, ignored their request and all this type of stuff. Gary, do you have somewhere on this desk that certified letter we mailed to them? That was mailed to the REF, Morey, the executive director. Now, if you can hold that up for the camera to look at. This was a certified letter that we mailed to Morey for a response. There it is. Yeah, they can see it on the monitor at home. And you can see right there, it's refused. They don't even want to know what we are trying to tell them.
And Larry, what's that on the back?
And on
that's
the back,
the
you know, there's
form,
the there's
the
you know
the form.
Yeah, we've got the return. If they had signed it and accepted it, they would have signed here, and this card would have come back to us.